Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Vessalatu vesselamu ala Rasulillahil Kerim. Euzu billahi mineşşeytanirracim. Rabbi şrah li sadri ve yessir li amri ve hlul ukdatan min lisani yefkahu kavli. Amma ba'd, fe inne hayral hadisi kitabullah, hayral hadi hadi Muhammedin sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem ve şerrü'l umuri muhdesatuha ve kullu muhdesatin bid'a ve kullu bid'atin dalalah ve kullu dalalatin fin nar. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to our the Muslim House series. Today we'll start our lecture number 8. Inshallah, we have done 12 recommendations from this book, how to make our house better, how to have a blessing in our house, and how we can develop our kids, what we need to teach to our wives, what we need to teach to our kids. These all things we have covered so far, alhamdulillah. In our last few recommendations, we learned about the ruling of houses, like how do you need to take the permission and the guest, and these all things we have discussed so far. If you have any question, you can ask me, inshallah. And all my series is on my YouTube channel. You can watch it as well, inshallah. So before I start my recommendation number 13, just as a reminder, I would like to say that always remember the purpose of your life. Always ask yourself, maybe once a month, maybe once a week, revise your purpose. What is your purpose of life? Why do you have kids? Why do you have family? Why do you want to get married? So always relate that, these all things which you have in the world, with what? With your purpose. And our purpose as a Muslim should be only paradise. That is our main purpose. We were not created for this world. So don't keep your purpose, your goal, limited to this life. Yes, you should set some goals for this life, but the real goal, real purpose should be paradise. You want to get married, you want to have kids, you want to have the kids, upbringing of the kids in an Islamic way, or you want to guide your wife, or whatsoever role you want to give within the community, your purpose should be paradise. You should be doing everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like you want to get married for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How is that possible? That you find the righteous wife, a wife who can help you with the things which will take you to the paradise. Your kids, you teach your kids, you grow up your kids in a way as per the sunnah, so when you die, even after your death, they can pray for you, so you can go enter into the paradise, or they can do the sadqa jariyah for you, or they spread the message which you have given to them as a beneficial knowledge as well. So everything should be related to the paradise, your house, everything. So inshallah, today we will start recommendation number 13. Again, very important recommendation, creating opportunities for meeting to discuss family matters. This recommendation is mainly about discussion with the family. Any matter you have, any problem you have, maybe that problem is within or outside the family. Maybe it's a financial discussion, maybe it's some plan for the next year, maybe plan for the Ramadan, maybe plan for the Hajj, for the Umrah, plans for the weddings, plan for anything. You should have some kind of discussions with your families. You should not leave everything to yourself or leave everything to someone else. You should gather maybe once a month, or maybe whenever it's necessary, you think you need to sit down with your wife, with your kids, you should do that. And also ask opinions from your kids as well. This will build confidence in your kids. Don't leave your discussions between you and your spouse. Invite your children as well. Maybe, of course, like we as a parents, we have more experience, but just to look at their views as well, their point of views, their discussion, or maybe they bring up something which you never thought about. So these all for these all things, we need to have discussion with the families. I think we, as a Muslim in our culture, we don't have this thing at all. We don't sit in the family discussions. Nothing. It does not happen. So we need to add this thing, family discussion. There are two kind of discussions. First discussion, as I mentioned, the general discussion that can be any planning or anything. Second discussion is again very important, which is with your discussion with your kids. Your discussion with your kids. Always remember that treat your kids with respect and maturity. If you will leave your kids as kids, they will always be kids. I mean to say that some families I know that their kids are, you know, 10 year or 12 year, but still they treat their kids, means their children, like they're just maybe 2 or 3 year old. If you will treat your kids like that, they will never become adult. I mean, they will never become mature. I know some mature boys, they are 13, 14, 15, and subhanAllah, like they have zero maturity. They don't know about anything that they don't know, because this is the culture of the home. They have been treated like kids always. Their parents think that their children will never become adult, or they will never become mature, because it is the responsibility of the parents to upbring them in a way in which they will be ready for the community, ready for the world. Thing is, what happened, I know some few people, actually few of my I would not say like whoever, but I know their families, they treated their children like kids even at the age of 16, 17. So what happens after 16, 17 or 18, these kids who have zero knowledge about anything about the world, all they know is they are nerdy people. All they know is the books, nothing about the dunya. And now this kid, when you send this kid to the universities, maybe to your own country or to any country, what will happen? That this kid will have independence now, and he will see the world now after 18 year old. And what happens? It's like a spring. This is how we push our children like that, and then when they go abroad, they're jumping like that, and then they go into the bad things. They go into the alcohol, they start smoking, they start living with, they start having the drugs and all kind of bad things. They start having and the girlfriends and these old things, because you never told them anything about the dunya. About the dunya means the mature. You never thought that they are mature. You never wanted them to grow. So from the very young age, you need to start building the base. Stop making or your kids as kids. As soon in Sharia, as soon as a kid is 13 or 14, khalas, and he has reached to the puberty period, he's adult now. He's no more kid after 13 or 14. This is not Islam that he will become adult after 18 or 19. No, in Islam, a kid is adult at the age of 13 or 14, and some scholars say 15 as well, but not more than 15 year old. So when he reached to that stage, he's adult now. You need to speak to him in a mature way. You cannot speak to him like he's just 5 year old. No, you have to change your mind, and you have to accept this thing that now he's adult. So now we come to the second part of the discussion, which we lack. Our families literally lack this thing. A adult discussion, like I would say adults discussion, because when a boy or a girl, she reached to the puberty, she's adult, he's adult. Now you have to speak to them, maybe one-on-one counseling with them, and tell them the rulings about these things. What is happening with them when they are, how they are having these bad dreams. Tell them the Islamic ruling of najasa, how do they have to do the ghusl, and what is the difference between the madi, mazi, and these old things? You should tell them when they reach to the age of 12 or 13. But unfortunately, we are too shy to have this discussion with our kids. And then what happens? They take, if you will not give them, they will take this discussion from outside, from the wrong company. They will take this discussion. They will have their knowledge from outside. So why don't you give them the knowledge and you show them that these are the barriers. You cannot cross the limits. What you need to do, like in these old cases, like when the kid, I think I've mentioned this thing before as well, when the kid is 11 or 12, yes, we know, and every parents will tell the kids, you should not go outside with this friend, or you should not smoke, smoking is not good. But what about the Islamic rulings? Why don't we feel it importance that Islam is important as well? Yes, smoking is not good for health, but it is more important to tell them about najasa, about what do they have to do, how they have to do the ghusl. Subhanallah, like 25-year-old, 26-year-old, when they have to get married, then they start asking these questions. How do we have to do the ghusl? Like, does that mean you were adults from last 12 to 14 years and you never felt to have a ghusl? How is this possible? It is not possible. And I'm not saying that you do it by yourself, haram. But while sleeping, you can have these things. And you don't know the difference between the money, the wazi, these things you don't know. How is this possible? This is the mistake from the parents. You have to tell your kids, make them mature. From 12, 11, when they reach 11, 12, you feel that they are adult now, speak to them, tell them. If you will not tell them, again, someone else will tell them. The women, the mothers, they need to sit with their daughters and tell them about these ayams, the 7 days, the periods. They have to pray, how they have to take the ghusl, and these old things. They should know these things. This is not the responsibility of the husband to teach them at the age of 25 or 26. They should know these rulings at the very age when they become adult, which is 13 or 14, maybe sometime it's earlier than that as well, or maybe 1 year later as well. So this discussion is very important. And also tell them about the life, about the world, about Islam, the ruling of Islam with other things as well. If you, especially to those kids, to those parents who want to send their children to non-Muslim countries, they should give them very like a strong knowledge, a strong base about Islam. Aqeedah, Tawheed, make these things very strong. If these things will not be strong, if they are not praying, if they are not praying, if their Aqeedah is not strong, their Tawheed is not strong, they don't know the rulings of basic things, Wallahi, I have experience. I went in abroad for studies. I have experience. If they don't have these old things, there are 95% chance that they will go to the wrong path. They will choose the wrong path because they don't have aqeedah. They don't know how to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't know what are the things which will actually guide them to the paradise. If they will not have the iman, then how will they save themselves from any kind of sins? That's why I have seen people going from the Muslim countries, wallahi, drinking alcohol, going to the clubs, and they don't mind. They say it's okay. We are in different culture now. This everything, each these old things are responsibility of the parents. Wallahi, you will be asked for these things. Don't send your kids to the non-Muslim countries then. But still, for universities, you will have to send them anywhere. Our countries are safe. SubhanAllah, I felt like I was in UK, and I felt the my friends or other children which I see now, they're going to our own country, Muslim country. Wallahi, they are suffering more. They're into drugs. They're into other things which in the Muslim countries we don't have, non-Muslim countries. So you have to prepare your kids, prepare them for everything, prepare them how they have to fight and handle the things. Moving on, one more advice for the parents is that about the culture differences. Thing is, you want your kids, or most of the parents, they want their kids to be like them, right? Ask yourself, how much you are like your parents? How much you are following their cultures? So forget about this thing. You have to give them Islamic culture. Forget about all other cultures, all other environments. Give them Islamic culture. Whatever culture you are following, now they should follow Islam. If you are not following Islam at the very young age, teach them that. Don't give them all other things. With time, they will have, inshallah. But the most important thing is Islam, their prayers, their tawheed. Wallahi, tawheed is the most important thing. If they don't know that about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a question to everyone, if you don't know what is shirk, how can you say that you don't do shirk? How can we say that? If we don't know about oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how can we say that I am on tawheed? We cannot say that. Do you say that you have a master degree without having any knowledge or without reading or doing anything? You cannot say that for the dunya. Then how can you say that for Islam? How can you say that I am perfect in prayers? If you don't know the sunnah way of prayers, how does the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to pray? So Islam, important. It will change your life. It will help you throughout your life. Wallahi, if you will not have money, if you will not have anything, if you have Islam, khalas, alhamdulillah, you have everything. But if you don't have Islam and you have everything else, you have nothing. So protect yourself and your families from the hellfire. This is a very, very important thing. Moving on to the next recommendation. Not showing, this is recommendation number 14, not showing family conflicts in front of children's. Not showing that to your children's. In every family, there are conflicts. There are fights, no doubt. You will never find any person who says we never fight it. Alhamdulillah. If there are some people, the God-gifted people, alhamdulillah, very good. But you will face some kind of conflicts between your spouses or between any member of the family. Don't do that in front of your children's. Don't discuss your conflicts with your children's. Means that you fight in front of your children's. This is very bad. You're yelling at your spouse in front of your children. Imagine what will be going, what your kid, maybe he's 3, 4, 5 year old, what he will be thinking. So don't do that in front of your children. You don't have to yell at all on your wife. There are some things which we need to learn how we have to treat our wives. I'll tell you, I'll give you one hadith. One hadith. I always have to get back to this book for many things. This book of manner, very important book. Subhanallah. If you want to learn the manners of things, of many things, you'll find the manners of how to treat your wife, how to treat your guest, about whatever you want to name it. There are 14 or I think 16 chapters in that in this book, and 22 chapters in this book. The manners of the bathroom, the manners of the masjid, the manners of the sleeping, the manners of sneezing, interacting with your brothers, wife, everything you will find. So we need to have this book in our houses as well. As I mentioned, the Islamic library, how you need to or what you need to have. So you need to have this book as well. Very important book, subhanAllah. May Allah bless them. And Sheikh Madroom, my Sheikh, is teaching this book. And I think we finished this book, actually. We're on the last chapter. I just want to mention one hadith regarding how you have to treat your wife. And then we can move on. Because this is big problem. Husband and wife fighting, this is big problem. You first thing is, the problem is with the husband as well. And of course with the wife, I don't want to discuss the wife's problem. I don't want to discuss that. But the husband problem, you cannot get 100%. This is dunya. Even when you want to look for a wife, wallahi, I know some people, they want everything. Nikab, hijab, prayer, tahajjud, hafiza, everything they want. And themselves, subhanAllah, like they're not hafiz, no beard, nothing. But what they want is 100%. First thing, you cannot get 100% from this dunya. It is not possible. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling that thing, that maybe you will dislike one thing and you will like one thing. That means that it is not possible that you will like everything in your wife, in your spouse. There will be things. Maybe there's some wife, everything is bad, and maybe something that is good as well. So we need to find out that good thing in our spouses in order to control these fights between the husband and wife. And this hadith, in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, follow my command. This is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he started with that. Follow my command. Treat women well and with kindness. For woman was created from the rib. For woman was created from the rib. And the most crooked part of a rib is its upper part. And if you were to go to straighten it, you would break it. And if you were to leave it, it would remain crooked. So treat women well with kindness. So subhanAllah, what is this hadith telling us? A woman, she was created from the rib, the most crude part. If you want to straighten her, it will break. You cannot make a woman straight. All you have to do is, you have to politely try your best. Maybe something you dislike, another thing you will like. SubhanAllah. So always remember this thing. You will never get 100% thing. Maybe a hafiza, you will get a hafiza or everything. I know for someone, he got married to hafiza, and mashallah, this brother was very good. But after married, khalas, gone. Her wife, no hijab, nothing. Just what will do with the hafiza if you don't know about anything else? So when you want to look for a wife, or similar to the to sisters, when you want to look for the brother, don't look for 100%. You cannot get 100% thing. Like, there is nothing like 100%. Maybe there will be closer to that, 70%. In the case of the girls, maybe it's 40%. But look for the basic things. Look for the akidah, hijab, praying, these old things. For the brothers, they are having beard. It is very important. I was reading the fatwa of Sheikh Fawzan, in which a question was asked by a sister, can she marry someone without the beard? Sheikh Fawzan said, no, you should not marry the one who does not love the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanallah. So if you want to look for the advices, if you want to know what kind of boys we want to look, what kind of sisters we want to look, there are books on that. You can, if you follow that, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, your life will be easy. But the problem is, we don't want to follow the Islamic laws and Islamic things, the Islamic culture. We want to do whatever our desires or our heart is saying, or whatever our family is pressurizing us. May Allah protect us all. So, do not speak to your mother, and the mother says to him, do not speak to your father. Means you're telling your kid, don't speak to your father. If something happened, you're telling your kid, don't speak to your mother. So you are involving your kids as well with these fights. So the child is confused and filled with turmoil. And the entire family lives in an atmosphere of what? Of no blessing, hostility. We should try to avoid the conflicts as much as possible, especially when you have kids. Don't do that in front of them. And the advices which I've given for the wife, don't break them. If they are not doing something, it is like the men and the women, they're very different, very different. Allah created them different. Subhanallah, Allah created them different. They both are not the same. Maybe, and mostly it happens, if somebody will tell you something, yalla, go start pray. Maybe the next day you will start following their advice or any kind of advice. But it's not the same case with the woman. Maybe you will tell her 100 times. 100 times you will tell her and she will not do that. So be patient. Always remember, women are different. You cannot make them straight. It is not possible. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All you can do is you can keep on advising them and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahi, the key, from whom the guidance will be coming? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to fix our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah fix my wife, change her mood or change her, like whatever you want. It is Allah, creator of everything. We need to know how we need to ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, he's the king of the whole universe, and he's not like a normal king. He's the king of the kings. He's the king and he's the creator of your spouse as well. If you are suffering with your spouses, you have fights every day, you need to get back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You need to fix your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ask Allah, Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa dhurriyatina qurrata ayun waj'alna lilmuttaqina imama. This dua is a magical dua. Do this dua, recite it in the sujood. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, you are the closest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said, when my servant asks you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about me, concerning me, I am indeed near. We are near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Any problem, any difficulty with our family, with our work, with our financial problems, it is Allah we have to get back to, inshallah. So these were the two recommendations. Inshallah, I'll see you again tomorrow with more recommendation to make our house more blessed, a blessing as per the recommendation from the Quran and the Sunnah. I hope these sessions are beneficial, and inshallah we'll try our best to continue in Ramadan as well. Not sure about the timing, maybe we can discuss tomorrow, or maybe the timing will be after the Taraweeh, most probably, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. If you have any questions with regards to the family or with regards to Ramadan, with regards to Zakat or anything, you can message me your question, inshallah, and I will get back to you with the answers. Until then, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. Jazakumullah khair.